So folks, before we begin on this Bento tour, we've just launched on Product Hunt. You can check the link out in the description and any support you can offer would be amazing. Feel free to comment below when you have.
Hello everyone. Today's video, I wanted to dive into the Bento application. We're going to give you a guided tour of how the app works and how to really optimize it in your daily routine. Now, as you can imagine, there's plenty of applications out there, and we've tried to approach this in a very different way. Our mission is to help you do less, but more meaningful tasks. And we've designed the application to be simple and a bit easier to be able to achieve that goal of doing less, but more meaningful tasks in your day. And the great thing is Bento isn't just an app, it's a methodology. So it's designed to help you grow and improve in the way that you manage your tasks and prioritization. So let's dive into the application, and I've included below in the link in the description some more about the methodology if you wanted to explore that. So as you can see from the outset, this application is very simple, but it is very relaxing to use with these beautifully designed animated themes. Now I'm going to start off by creating a new Bento box, and to do that I press this button here. Now, before we go ahead and pack our box, we need to choose a workflow that best suits our day. This is very simply the order in which you do the tasks, and this can be changed each day for each box. So for example, Eat That Frog is great for people who want to start with the hardest task first and finish with the smallest one. And Slow Burn is more suitable for those who start with the smallest task and work to the largest task. In this case, an example, we're going to choose Eat That Frog. So as you can see here, we've got an empty Bento box to start us out. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give this a title. And in this case, we're going to call it Monday. I can also choose an emoji if I want to. Maybe I'll choose something like a sunny day background. So as you can see here, there are three different areas: large, medium, and small task. So let's go and populate these. So as you can see here, a large task appears. A large task should be about 90 minutes long and should be a lot more sort of creative or deliverable led, something intense enough to do that will produce a good quality output. So for example, maybe it's something like write report. Now I'm going to go over to my medium task. Now this might be something process based. So for example, in my case, it might be an email campaign, and they should be between 45 minutes and 60 minutes long. You can change the time here. In this case, I'm going to choose 60 minutes for this task. And I'm going to go over to small. Small should be anything that's administration based or personal well-being based. So for example, I might even put yoga session here for 15 minutes. Now the reason we kept it 3 is because we wanted to limit you on how many tasks that you can add in the system. We typically overwhelm our systems, and as this is a companion app, we wanted to have you do less overall. So here are my 3 tasks for the day. Now as you can imagine, it's really key for me to start focusing in on each of them. And as I said, I chose the Eat That Frog methodology. So as you can see, the largest task is at the top and the smallest task is at the bottom. But I can naturally change that about if I want to. If I hold down on a box, I can change the workflow. For example, if I wanted to start with the medium task, go to the large task and finish with the small one, that's called Climb That Summit. So there we go, it's changed them around for me. So that's perfect. For example, if your energy levels change across the day. So obviously I'm now going to start with the email campaign. So I'm going to press this arrow button on the right hand side. Now, as you can see, I'm going to start a timer and focus on this work. Now, the great thing about the timer is we've actually included some really relaxing music so that you can focus in on your task. And as you can see, it blocks out any other distractions. For example, even the list of other tasks that you've got, so that you've got that one task mode, a real focus mode that means you're channeling your attention into this one task. And it reveals the gorgeous animations for you to have a look at while you're working on the task. But don't get too distracted, even though how relaxing they are. So as you can see, if I pause the timer will pause in that location. and a progress bar will pop up at the top. Now, as you complete your tasks, say for example, in this case, I actually did complete the email campaign, you can see that the celebration appears, but that progress bar drops down, indicating how much you've got left of your day's focus. Now, as you can see, I can work on my other tasks if I wanted to, which is really helpful. And I can even go in and modify what those tasks are if the day changes around me. Now, some of the few things that I wanted to talk about are the themes. As I said, the experience is very relaxing. So if I go up to the top right-hand corner and press the settings cog, you can see other themes become available. For example, we've got this beautiful sushi bar theme, and you can see it's gorgeous, really relaxing to use, especially when you're in that focus mode. You can see the fish pop up. And you can also choose our Zen Garden mode. As you can see, really relaxing to use as well. There's also light mode as well. If you switch dark mode off, you can now get light mode, which is also really nice during the daytime. Let's go back to dark mode. You can also see that you can switch the haptics and audio off here too. And you're probably wondering what this book is over on the left-hand side. This is a simple methodology guidance, helping you to understand how the Bento method works in a bit more detail. So, let's talk a little bit about templates. Now, we're evolving this concept for future versions, but templates are a handy way to implement three simple tasks that might be something you do on a routine basis. Let's say you have a 15-minute journal routine. You could use this one to accomplish that. For example, if I press use template, it populates the Bento box, and I can start working on three successes in 5 minutes, two gratitudes, and one improvement. And that helps me to really focus in on the task at hand. And I can use and choose a few others, and we're going to adapt this in future versions too. So that's a little bit more about Bento. Now, the concept itself is something that we're continually growing, and the methodology is something that we're really excited that you can use in a wide variety of applications. But Bento is the main place to use the application. Just a few extra things that might be helpful for those users who are looking to take it a bit further. One of the things you can do is reset the box. This is quite helpful if you wanted to restart the box and accomplish new tasks. And for example, you can delete it if you want to. It does a confirmation on whether you want to delete it, but that's quite helpful. For example, if you wanted to set up your whole week worth of tasks, then you can do. We'll do a few more videos about how you can use Bento a bit more in your routine, but this is really an overview of how the application works. Thank you very much, folks, and we hope you found this video useful. You can download Bento on iOS today, and Android is going to be coming very soon.